right now on Fox News Sunday. And hello again from Fox News in Washington. We'll get to our interviews with Secretary Clinton and Speaker Boehner in a moment. But first, the latest on the situation in Egypt. For the sixth straight day, thousands took to the streets of Cairo and other major cities to protest the country's authoritarian government. President Mubarak named his intelligence chief, Omar Suleiman, vice president. But U.S. officials say Mubarak can't just reshuffle the deck and stand pat. For more, let's bring in Fox News correspondent Greg Palcott, who is live in Cairo. Greg.
Chris, this is the sixth day of unrest in Egypt, and thousands of protesters are coming out in the street. They are mostly gathering at Tahrir or Liberation Square. That has been the scene of bloodshed, clashes between protesters and police. And tonight in that square, former nuclear watchdog chief and current government critic here, Mohammed al-Baradei, showed up and met with protesters. He has been under house arrest. He wants to be the next president here. Critical of Mubarak. He says he's getting a mandate from the street for a national unity government. Earlier in the day, we were there as tanks rolled into the square. The Egyptian army playing a major role now in securing the city as well as the country in place of the riot police, which have been pulled back, which caused so much problems. Their absence has led to insecurity in various areas of the country. All this as American tourists and others are cramming the airport here in Cairo, trying to get out. The U.S. Embassy saying today that they recommend American tourists here should consider leaving, and those considering coming should not. Also, certain American diplomats and families being advised that perhaps they should leave. We are told that more planes being laid on for tomorrow to ensure the exodus of these individuals. All this as the Egyptian President Hosni Mubarak tries to put up a show that he is in control, that he is in charge. State television showing him at a military command center today. He was there with his new vice president choice, Omar Suleiman, and he was directing the security efforts regarding the rioters, and he even flew some of his Egyptian Air Force fighter planes over the city. Chris.
Greg Palcott reporting from Cairo. Greg, thanks for the update. Joining us now from the State Department, Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. Secretary, President Obama on Friday called on Mubarak to recognize the rights of the Egyptian people. Are you satisfied with the steps that Mubarak has taken so far?
Oh, I don't think anyone is satisfied, least of all the Egyptian people who have legitimate grievances and are seeking greater political freedom, a real path to democracy and economic opportunity. And for 30 years, the United States, through Republican and Democratic administrations, has been urging the Mubarak government to take certain steps. In fact, we've been urging that a vice president be appointed for decades, and that finally has happened. But there's a long way to go, Chris. And our hope is that we do not see violence. We see a dialogue opening that reflects the full diversity of Egyptian civil society, that has the concrete steps for democratic and economic reform that President Mubarak himself said that he was going to pursue, and that we see the respect for human rights for Egyptian people and the kind of progress that will lead to a much more open political and economic set of opportunities for the Egyptian people.
Secretary, all of your answer has been couched in terms of President Mubarak. Does that mean that the Obama administration still backs Mubarak as the legitimate president of Egypt?
Well, we have been very clear that we want to see a transition to democracy, and we want to see the kind of steps taken that will bring that about. We also want to see an orderly transition. Right now, from everything we know, the army has taken up positions. They are responding very positively thus far to the peaceful protests, but at the same time, we have a lot of reports of looting and criminal activity that is not going to be particularly helpful to what we want to see happen, and that has to be dealt with. So there are many, many steps along the journey that has been started by the Egyptian people themselves, and we wish to support that.
Secretary, you talk about an orderly transition. How concerned are you that if Mubarak were to be suddenly thrown from power, that Islamic radicals could fill the void?
Chris, we want to see an orderly transition so that no one fills a void, that there not be a void, that there be a well-thought-out plan that will bring about a democratic, participatory government. And I also believe strongly that this is in Egypt's long-term interests. It's in the interests of the partnership that the United States has with Egypt. So that is what we are attempting to promote and support, because clearly what we don't want is chaos. I don't think the Egyptian people want that. They want their grievances to be addressed. We also don't want to see some takeover that would lead not to democracy but to oppression and the end of the aspirations of the Egyptian people. So this is an intensely complex situation. It does not lend itself to, you know, quick yes or no, easy answers. But instead, I think the path that President Obama has charted, that we are pursuing, that calls for no violence, that supports the aspirations and human rights of the Egyptian people, that stands behind concrete steps toward democratic and economic reform, is the right path for all of us to be on.
Secretary, on Tuesday, after the protests had already started in Cairo, you said this.
Our assessment is that the Egyptian government is stable and is looking for ways to respond to the legitimate needs and interests of the Egyptian people.
A number of protesters in the streets said, based on that remark and other actions, that the U.S. was acting on the side of the regime, not of the protesters. Was that statement by you a mistake?
You know, Chris, we recognize the volatility of the situation, and we are trying to do exactly what I have just said, to promote orderly transition and change that will respond to the legitimate grievances of the Egyptian people, which is what the protests are all about. I don't think anyone wants to see instability, chaos, increasing violence. That is not in anyone's interest. So what President Obama and I have been doing is sending a very clear message about where the United States stands. We want to see an orderly transition to a democratic government, to economic reforms, exactly what the protesters are seeking. At the same time, we want to recognize Egypt has been our partner. They've been our partner in a peace process that has kept the region from war for over 30 years, which has saved a lot of lives, Egyptian lives, Israeli lives, other lives. We want to continue to make it absolutely American priority that what we've been saying for 30 years is that real stability rests in democracy, participation, economic opportunity. How we get from where we are to where we know the Egyptian people want to be and deserve to be is what this is about now. So we are urging the Mubarak government, which is still in power. We are urging the military, which is a very respected institution in Egypt, to do what is necessary to facilitate that kind of orderly transition.
And briefly, Secretary, should Americans currently in Egypt leave the country?
Well, we are following the conditions for American citizens extremely closely. This is one of my highest responsibilities, Chris. And we have authorized voluntary departure, which means that we will assist American citizens to leave Egypt. We have warned that there should not be any non-essential travel to Egypt. Thankfully, right now, there are no reports of Americans killed or injured. Again, I thank the Egyptian army for the support and security that they have provided. But we are watching it closely, and we are assisting Americans who wish to leave.
Secretary Clinton, we want to thank you so much for talking with us today.
Thank you very much.
Joining us now here in studio is Congressman John Boehner for his first Sunday show interview since being elected Speaker of the House. And Mr. Speaker, welcome back to Fox News Sunday.
Chris, good to be with you.
Should our government continue to back Egyptian President Mubarak, and what about the $1.5 billion in U.S. aid to that country?
Well, I think the administration, our administration so far, has handled this tense situation pretty well.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us.
THillaryClinton.com.